I'll be careful. Ah!
You and a warm welcome to Taskmaster, or as my nan calls it, what, that silly thing you do where you pretend you're cross because a comedian hasn't counted some ducks properly or something? Get lost, Nan! You haven't even seen it! You've been dead for 15 years! You're such a chopsy nan! Why can't you just say, ooh? Have they not got a ghost knitting club? Back in this dimension, things are going well for some and really badly for others. Please welcome our Earthly Five, who are still alive. They are Dara Ó Briain, Fern Brady, Kearns, Munya Chawawa, and Sarah Millican. And next to me, a man who dots the I's and crosses the T's. He wets the bed he likes to please. He cries a lot, his winkle smells, and he still shoplifts to get attention. It's a little Alex Horne!
Oh, hi. Oh.
Cool. How have you been since the last show?
Terrific, thank you. I've joined a cult.
Oh, have
love
you?
Love it, love it. Love the cult, yeah. Just a small one, just the three of us, me, my wife, Alan. That's it. Just the three of us in Alan's vehicle.
Right, and what are you doing there?
Never you mind, Greg.
Right then, on with the show proper. What's the old prize task then?
Great question, Greg. I'm on it, Papa GD. And today, you have asked them to bring in the best thing you've ever received in the post.
Ooh.
Hey guys, remember post? They shove stuff through a hole in your door. Greg here will give 5 points to the person he thinks has brought in the best thing they've received in the post, and then at the end of the show, the overall winner will take home all 5 things to start a new life in a new home. It's very post-modern.
Munya!
So, I have bought in the Suckatron 3000.
Here it is.
This isn't the official name, so don't Google it, because I don't know what's going to come up. Greg, you ever been sat there on your laptop devouring a bag of crisps and you look down at the keyboard and there's enough crumbs to feed a small family? Yep. Has that ever happened to you?
Of course it has.
OK, now...
Have a look.
This thing here sucks those crumbs.
By the way, I have Googled Suckatron 3000.
Yeah. Ooh!
It comes up somewhere.
God, that looks like it smells. Sarah, can you beat a mini vacuum?
So, from the age of about 10 or 12, I've loved Philip Schofield. And I had a lot of posters of him, and I took a photo of myself, of me in my bedroom, with my perm and all of my posters of Philip Schofield, and I sent it to him, presumably for him to keep. He sent it back.
Just came through the post to Sarah.
Oh. Whoa!
That shit is weird.
Look how pleased I am.
He's not on the crucifix, is he?
A true fan.
It's sort of so on the line between being quite sweet and being terrifying. This is very strong so far.
Okay, so far, who's next?
Fern.
I don't know if this is the best thing or the worst thing, but for years now, my mum has been sending me the most unbelievably ugly pants that I've ever seen.
Here are Fern's mum's pants.
My mum, I believe, was sending me these as some sort of chastity belt type thing.
And was there a note with them?
Just this is a little present for you.
Love, mum.
Yeah.
John, can you beat some special pants?
I've gone down the same route Sarah has.
Okay.
Nostalgia.
Yep.
My Dennis the Menace fan club membership and badges.
Here it is.
Sweet. I'm surprised, John, because I was a member of that as well. But surely it's a significant gulf in our ages.
Yeah, 2 generations I had down.
All right.
You know, if you met another member.
Which you just have.
Yeah, so I say ding, you say...
Dong.
Dong stood for Dennis Owns Naughty Nasher. Can't I can't remember what ding stood for.
Dennis is never good is the ding one.
Ah. Yeah. That's really sweet, John, and very clever, because you've tapped into my childhood as well. Dara.
I brought in a thing that shouldn't be sent in the post, which is an entire turkey.
Here it is.
Wow.
My mother's cousins lived in County Mayo. They had a farm. And every Christmas, they would send us the turkey we ate at Christmas. This was full turkey, head squeezed in, box just wrapped around it, misshapen. You'd pop it up like whatever. Proper pre-butcher turkey in the post. And we'd collect it from the post depot every year, around about mid-December.
Yeah, someone's going to win that tonight. It's best thing to receive through the post, Greg. What's the worst thing to receive through the post?
I mean, probably the worst thing to receive, and I think she'd agree with me, is Fern's mum's pants.
Don't keep saying mum's pants, because she might be upset when this goes out.
You're only getting 1 point, and she's going to be angry anyway.
What? I'm only getting one.
It's the best that...
Oh, yeah. It's the best thing.
Yeah. Right, so 1 point to Fern Brady.
I mean, in many ways, it's the thing that makes my heart sing the most. But I also think it's awful to get a turkey through the post. That's not the best thing.
That was our Christmas.
I'm not suggesting for a second that your Christmases weren't heartbreaking, Doug.
OK, so 2 points to Dara Ó Briain.
He tapped into my childhood. We crossed the generations, like the true ding-dong as we are. I'll give him 3 points.
OK, 3 points to John Kearns. Yeah, well done. So it's the top two now, Munya or Sarah? God,
let me tell you. My keyboard looks like a war zone. But I'm only going to give it 4 points.
Oh.
Obviously, the best thing to get through the post is a picture of Sarah Millican surrounded by Philip Schofields. Everyone knows that. There it is, five points.
Well done, Sarah Millican.
Well, what's first, please?
Milk.
Hello.
Hello, Munya.
Oh, I love milk.
Microwaves and plinth. Milk or microwaves?
Is this what we're having for tea?
Bread. Peas.
Yes, there's 5 minutes to go on that. And there is just a minute to go on what appears to be just bread.
Is this just your lunch? It's a lot of peas for one person. I would worry about your guts.
Do you like peas?
I don't like milky peas.
And there's a metal bowl there as well.
Yeah.
So stuff's got to get mixed.
Stuff's got to get mixed.
Shall I open my task?
I wouldn't open it yet.
OK.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't open it yet. Wouldn't open it yet if I were you.
No.
I wouldn't open it just yet.
Why?
I'm just saying I wouldn't open it yet.
I should open this because, you know, this thing's counting down.
Yeah.
And you just said, well, I wouldn't if I were you. Well,
I wouldn't if I were you.
But that's the kind of thing where it'll get to 2 minutes, you go, why didn't you open it?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not allowed to look at this yet?
You're allowed to look at that whenever you want.
You said no, though.
You're allowed to. I'd say I wouldn't if I were you.
Why?
I know what's in it.
All of you. How does it make you feel when Alex does something like that? What emotional response?
No, I'm sorry, are we doing therapy now?
Just wondering how it makes you feel about Alex, that's all.
I feel powerless.
Come on then, Milky Peas.
Oh, I've got a nickname. Well, we're going to begin by standing firm with John and Fern.
Well, when do I open it?
Whenever you want. Wouldn't open it yet if I were you.
Yeah, but you're not me.
What's your name?
John.
Star sign?
Kearns.
Really?
What did you ask
me? Star sign.
Well, people usually go first name.
Right.
Then they go last name.
Right.
Aries.
28 minutes.
Place of birth?
St. Thomas's Hospital.
Are you opening it?
Do you want me to open it?
I wouldn't open it.
But why are you saying that?
It's your star sign.
Gemini.
How high can you jump?
Ooh. Foot.
Ah, bread's ready.
What's the other questions?
Who's your favourite singer, John?
Rufus Wainwright.
Yuck. Ah. A couple more questions if you want them.
Yeah, go on.
Phobias?
No, nothing.
Biggest regret?
I'm not going to say I haven't lived my life without regrets, but I tend not to dwell on them.
Just give me a regret.
I don't really have any, but I'm not one of these kind of people that doesn't have regrets.
You do have regrets?
I've got regrets, yeah.
Right, what's the biggest one?
Have
you been to Greece?
You know, you're mad, huh?
Have you been to Greece?
No.
Right.
Within 30 seconds of opening this task,
you must pick up both milk bottles and hold them directly above the microwaves.
The clock stops when a milk bottle, hand
or arm, touches the microwave or is no longer directly above a microwave.
Lowest number on the clock wins, but if the clock reaches zero, you're disqualified. I'm a strong boy.
I'm not joking. I've had a shoulder injury recently that, and I can't.
There we go. Thank you.
A few regrets now.
Mm-hmm. I tried to warn you. It's just struck the mic with this, I'll stop the clock. That's why I didn't want you to open the task.
Why?
Well, so the clock would go down more.
Oh, so it's okay, so someone might do worse.
Yeah, someone might do worse.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
I quote John during the actual task, fuck this.
Because he kept asking me my biggest regret.
You don't have regrets, although you're not someone who doesn't have regrets.
I've got regrets. We've all got regrets.
We've all got regrets.
But I don't live with them.
So where are they?
Oh, they're up there. But I don't go there.
You don't. You shut the door.
Oh, they're high. They're top shelf.
They're top shelf.
You can't reach them.
Too high. You can't get to them.
I can't get to my regrets.
Fine. Enjoy that task.
No, I did have a shoulder injury.
How'd you injure your shoulder?
I went to the gym and then I was trying to compete with the man next to me.
Do you regret the whole thing down the gym or not?
Yeah, I do really regret it. It really messed me up for ages and then meant I messed up that task.
Well, maybe take that regret and pop it in John's mind shelf. All right, it's the end of part one. We're going to have a break while you have a conversation about doing an online food shop. You used to make love. So make love now. He'll time you.
Go.
Welcome back to Taskmaster. It's part two, and there's a lab-based task in play.
Yes, and it's a fiendish one. Next up, it's Dairy Dara Sarah Milky Cam and the Milkman Munya. Here we go. What's your star sign?
Aquarius.
I've got more questions.
I bet you do.
What's your name?
Sarah.
Sarah.
Milliken.
How high can you jump, or what's the highest you've ever jumped?
Just little, like the size of a mouse.
What's your name?
No, I'm not playing. Let me check this. Within 30 seconds of opening this task,
you must pick up both milk bottles and hold them directly above the microwaves.
Any opinions on milk?
Gives me the shits.
How much do you need to have?
I wouldn't want that amount.
That's 6 pints.
Might as well just pour it straight through.
But, Jesus, but if the clock reaches zero, you are disqualified.
Ah. Well, you...
Wait, what? Hang on, what? Wait. Wait, what?
Lift them above the microwaves, ready?
Right, OK.
Yes!
Well done.
You see that?
Yeah.
I've got to keep my biceps contracted like a constipated eagle.
Oh! It's exciting, isn't it? Even after all these years, isn't it exciting when a microwave pings?
Wait, what clock? Have I stopped?
Yeah, you stopped. Yeah, you put the mailboxes on the microwave.
Oh, no! Arse.
Oh, you know what? We're going to do it.
Hold them up. Ooh, I need to lift them up like that. This is heavy.
Yeah. Shoulders are starting to hurt a bit. Could technically raise my arms.
Yes, it must be over the directly over the microwave still.
I don't know if this is more difficult or easier.
It's impressive.
How long have I been doing this?
3 minutes.
At no point did you say that had to be full, though, did you? Take that off.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, it's done back for you. Sorry, everybody.
Aha. Like a milky torture.
Oh, that's it, Nick. Just drop the microwave. Yeah. Oh, now that's just touched there.
Oh, has it?
Yes, that's enough.
Oh, no, look at my boots.
Now, look at the floor, Sarah.
Oh, I should have tipped them out before.
I could have brought that to you.
Sorry, everybody.
To drain the milky vessels. Mm. Very clever.
Very clever.
I felt I didn't want to make a mess, and I felt really bad. I made such a mess.
Throughout the series, whenever like, when Munya, when you came into the lab, every time you went, it stinks in here. Throughout the series. That's her.
And if you think that's bad, you should go round to Dara's at Christmas.
So they cleaned and there was a pocket they couldn't find because it still stank and then eventually it was found.
It was under the flooring.
Millican's milky pocket. By stark contrast. Get a bit confused, old man?
That has haunted me, that task. And it is on a low rung of the regret shelves. Yes.
Oh, one you can easily access.
It's eye level. It is absolutely eye level.
Well, much like on a summer's day, if you're wandering through a meadow and you might just catch a beautiful butterfly, we've caught the moment where Dara realised that he's totally fucked this.
Wait, what? Hang on, what? Wait. Wait, what?
Yes.
So it's wait what?
Yes.
What wait?
Wait what?
Yeah.
Munya does everything with absolute commitment. Yeah. It's incredible. I imagine you clean your teeth like, let's do this.
In my mind, I felt like Moses in the Red Sea. It's cold in the milk, freaking, the microwave is blowing, that's Jesus whispering to me. Honestly, I had a vision.
Well, yeah, I mean, Sarah did it well in every single way. She delayed the most with the questions and then she found a technique, so she did well. Lowest number wins. Dara, unfortunately, comes last. 26 minutes, 55. Fern gets 2 points with 26 minutes and 4 seconds. Then Munya, who held them up for over 4 minutes, which is amazing. Each one is the weight of a chihuahua, genuinely. 25 minutes and 4 seconds. John held out longer than you, though. 23 minutes and 30 seconds. Sarah wins it, though, with 16 minutes and 58 seconds and 5 points.
Right. Scoreboard, please.
Well, I can tell you Dara and Fern are in joint last. John and Munya in joint second. Sarah, though, is in the lead with 10 points.
Well, I, for one, am ready for another.
Oh, well, I'm ready for a holiday.
iPad. Oh, Fern Brady.
Is that you?
That's me, yeah.
Dara Ó Briain?
Yes, that's me.
I'm waiting for Munya Chawawa.
Yes, that's me. You even spelled my name right. Sick.
Hello.
Welcome home.
Is this your suitcase?
No, that's your suitcase.
Oh, no.
Where are we off to today?
Get to the end of the lanes in exactly the same amount of time.
One lane, two lanes.
That time must be under 1 minute.
Closest two times wins.
Also, you must mirror yourself during your attempts.
There are 2 bonus points for the most stylish mirroring. Mirroring. Mirroring.
Both attempts must take place within the next 10 minutes.
This is lane one there.
Yeah.
On the flat.
Yeah.
This is lane two. It's a travelator.
Yeah.
And you want to reach to the ends of them at exactly the same time. I can tell you, if you were stationary on that,
yes,
it takes about 1 minute 25.
The time I do it in must be under a minute, so I cannot be stationary on it.
Mmm, sneaky, sneaky, sneaky.
Well, there's no point going quick on here, because that would mean I have to go double quick there.
Can you go double quick? Greg will give style points to the most stylish people.
From Greg? Style points from Greg.
Right, it's a pretty straightforward thing. Just a personal note, I absolutely love those things. I genuinely could ride one of those all day. It's not that interesting, but I'm never more at peace.
Shall I show them what they did?
Yeah, have a look at them, yeah.
First up, it's Sarah and Sarah. Good luck.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Very accurate.
Thank you.
It says do it stylishly.
I had a nice coat on.
Is that next? Here's what the Daras did.
His Soviet vibe you went for.
Really wasn't the music that was in my head for that. I was applied retrospectively.
Now it's time for Kearns' turn.
I don't think you'd expect me to skip like that.
Correct. It's quite a Willy Wonka vibe you had going on, I thought.
Yeah, I'm faster than I look. Yeah.
See, I'm making out of that. Yeah. You're making out. John is faster than he
looks. Well, I have to go into notes.
We're at the halfway point of this episode. We've reached the top of the hill. It's all downhill from here.
Whee!
Welcome back to Taskmaster. Can you remind us where we were, please, Alex?
Yes, we were at Gatwick Airport, Greg. The current task involves having two walks down two different lanes and trying to get to the finish line at the same time, mirroring your movement on each attempt. The only problem is one of the walks is on a moving travelator. Also, there are two bonus points for the most stylish mirroring, mirroring, mirroring. Talking of mirrors and styling, here is Munya.
Right, here we go. Here we go. So, 1, 2, 3, 10, 11, 12,
hello.
Yeah, yeah. Really good.
It's quite a thing of beauty to watch, I thought.
I was in awe, yeah.
Dara.
Did he ever cross the line?
Oh, like that, is it?
No, Dara, is this the man who held milk for a microsecond? Talking to me, Mr.
And
Wait,
you all
what, what, what,
had
what?
A big fucking party about that.
Hold me back, John, hold me back.
It would seem monstrous to strip him of his points, but I guess if that's what Dara wants.
Would you count that as the end of the walk, Greg? I suppose is the question.
Yeah, that's the big question, isn't it? I think enough of that case is over the line, that's
yeah.
What I think.
Yeah, Dara.
Who's left?
Well, finally, it's Fern.
Ready? Ready.
Sounds like you're a people's champion anyway. You talk us through your performance, Fern. From my point of view, I've written down lacklustre and wildly inaccurate.
I tried really hard. I feel like I don't know what's real anymore. Because at the time, I kind of thought that there was some airport staff and they were looking at me funny. But I thought, oh, they're just really jealous of my costume. I didn't know it was that bad.
Unfortunately, Fern, on one side of the path, she did it in 29 seconds, the other in 45 seconds. So there was a 16-second difference. In comparison, the two Daras had a 4-second difference, the two Munyas a 3-second difference, the two Johns, half a second difference. Sarah, negligible difference at
wow.
all. So Sarah definitely gets the 5 points.
Oh, no. Between Munya and John for the style points.
Most stylish mirroring.
Well, I think one style point each is fair.
One bonus style point to Munya and one to John.
OK. I'd like another lovely little task, please.
Good. Well, here's a lovely little task where they wear some lovely little messy hats. Dara.
Hello. Do you like this?
I think so. And actually, before you open, I just need to do something. Wait 1 second.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
Oh, no!
Here he comes.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Nothing.
That's just rude. You're really pushing me today, Alex. You know this.
You just put paint in my hat.
Yes.
Oh.
I ask what you're doing?
No.
All right.
Thanks, Polly.
You haven't made me wow. Yeah.
Strike the bullseye with your paint.
The bullseye must be round there, then. OK.
You must only step on the stepping stones and you must step on all the stepping stones.
Wait, what? No? Oh, Jesus!
Also, your hands must be below your waist at all times.
fastest wins. Your time starts now.
Interesting reaction from Dara after he'd spilt a little paint down his front when he was trying to get his head around the task.
Oh, do you want to hear it?
Yeah. Wait, what? No.
Good. Let's go. Yeah, so you've got to hit the target with your paint. You can only step on the stepping stones. You must step on all the stepping stones. Hands below the waist. Off we go. First up, it's Mun and Fun. Munya and Fern.
Your time starts now. OK, Alex, can you talk whilst I walk, yeah?
I think so.
What the hell? Alex!
Yes?
OK, I need to go back. I need to get some more.
You put paint on the flag.
Oh, no!
Right, we're back in this. Ah!
Is there paint in my hair?
Would you like a shower cap?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm in. Ah, this is something I learned from being a shop girl at uni. I've done it.
Yeah, I've stopped the clock.
I don't think of the other people I'm competing against often enough, so I'm thinking of them now, trying to think how I hate them.
Be careful on this bit.
Oops! Did you see that?
No.
Fuck's sake!
Yeah, it is a bit further than that. You're nearly there.
A bigger contrast between the two approaches you couldn't possibly see.
No, I was trying very hard during that one, but I'm not all like Munya leaping about and stuff.
No, I wrote down Munya is an unnecessary action hero. He does action hero moves when he could just step over to something.
When I was at uni, I used to be an American football team.
Yeah.
And our motto was speed and violence. So basically what that means is everything you do in life, speed and violence.
What about, like, knitting? Speed and violence.
I have a motto.
Oh, yeah.
It's in Latin. It is waitus whatus.
I mean, Munya was breathtaking to watch. There was a tiny little speck of paint in the bullseye. He did it in 1 minute 30. It was unbelievably quick.
No. But I thought that Fern was breathtaking to watch as well.
Yes, yes.
What is she doing?
5.5 minutes.
Come on, let's crack on.
All right, well, there's two more people now, and I've fudged their names together to make Sarah Millikearns. Sarah and John. So, hands below your waist.
Hands. Can I not do for balance?
Yeah, that's perfect.
That's a bit unfair.
Did you want to check the task?
Yeah.
Well, you can only step on stepping stones.
Oh, oh, you're kidding me!
Yeah, why? Well, I mean, yeah, I knew it.
Okay.
I mean, I've gone from there to there. I mean, it's madness how far I've gone.
All done.
Ah, you're reversing.
Right, you just got a stretch, haven't you?
Ah, well done, John.
Yeah.
How high is the camera? Oh, I've got pain!
You're through.
Oh.
Oh.
line.
Is there one in the bullseye?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well. Yeah.
The contrast with John was sensational. It's literally like watching an alien pretend to be human. Significantly worse than Fern.
Yes, 8 minutes and 3 seconds.
8 minutes?
8 minutes and 3 seconds, yes.
Christ, what was I doing?
Yeah. Fern's now looking pretty good, especially because we can see a picture of Sarah's hands just slightly above her waist.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, fair enough. They are a little bit.
High waisted trousers. Yeah. Yeah.
And sadly, I do have to show you this photo as well, Greg. This one here.
Yeah.
I do have to show you one other thing as well, which is this.
Oh no.
Step on all the stepping stones.
Yeah.
Got to speed this up.
Shall I go in here?
All the information's on the task, Munya.
You must step on all the stepping stones.
You're labouring that a bit.
You put paint on the flag.
Yeah, OK. I need this. Right, OK.
Right, we're back in this. We're back in.
They're dropping like flies!
I tried to warn them. I tried to help.
Just sounded like you were being really monotonous. They just sort of tuned you out.
Sorry, Alex. Please, all of them, please. It's like a bored bloke operating a funfair ride. It's the end of part three, and we're another step closer to someone being poisoned by Dara Ó Briain's raw turkey. 4 of 4.
Yes, and there are 4 losers over there who failed in obeying the simple instructions to step on all the stepping stones, hands below their waists, before striking the target with the paint. It's such a shame. Thankfully, there is still one ray of hope. But his name isn't Ray O' Hope, it's Dara Ó Briain.
Ray O' Hope.
Only stepping stones.
Lovely.
Wait, what?
Jesus.
All right. That should be enough for now.
Yeah.
That's got to make up for some of the other things in this episode, isn't it?
Wait, what?
Wastewater side, exemplary work. How are you feeling now, though?
There's this faint chink of light. I'm just waiting for the shoe to drop. I'm waiting for you to go, but then.
Come on, stop waiting for the shoe to drop.
No, it's great. It was great. Do you want to see the best bits, because it was so graceful?
Oh, yeah, that'd be nice.
OK. Here's Dara's best bits.
Yeah.
How much paint do I have now?
Chew.
I'm sorry.
Seems a little high.
I think it's awful, Dara. It's an awful way to end, but that's Taskmaster.
It would have been quick. 4 minutes 45.
Oh, I mean, not quick as well.
Yeah, not as quick as Munya, of course, 1 minute 30, but nobody completed the task.
So nobody gets a point.
What? Ooh.
Is there any point in looking at the scores after that?
Probably not, but let's do it anyway. She's in the lead with 15 points. It's Sarah Milliken! Hey!
OK, everyone, before you head up to the stage, Alex has a very important question for you.
Yes, I do. I'll start with you, Dara. Inches or feet?
Inches.
Fern, inches or feet?
Feet.
John?
Feet.
Munya?
Feet.
And then finally, Sarah Milliken.
Inches.
Thank you.
Curiouser and curiouser. Good. Please make your way to the stage for the final task of the show!
They got what they wanted.
I don't know what's more heartbreaking, short or long. Who's going to read the task, Alex?
John is going to read the task.
Right, John.
Paint a picture of a unicorn using your head brush. You may not handle your head brush at any point. You have 2 minutes.
That's it. Paint a picture of a unicorn. Would you like them to paint a specific unicorn?
I'd like him to be prancing.
You have 2 minutes. Starting. Please step back on your circles.
Show me them prancers.
You're going to start with Dara Ó Briain.
The short brush has got to be an advantage, surely.
Is it, though?
Oh.
Is it?
Oh! Oh! That is one jaunty prancer.
Hello, Fern.
Hello. Here we go!
Which end's which?
Well, it's got a horn coming out with some green and different colours.
Oh, yeah.
What I see is two fences, a big orange and a pepper.
Hello, John.
Hi, hi.
Can I regret this?
Yeah, of course. You know where the horn is, though, at least.
I know where the big red line is. It's next to the four green lines.
Not bad. Not bad.
Not bad. It looks like a long-legged lobster. But at least it looks like a creature.
And finally, hello, Sarah.
Hi.
Oh. Oh. Lovely.
I tried to show movement, but that just ended up as flowers.
It looks like Troy's horse. It's a powerful beast.
Thanks.
Oh, you're so welcome. You lot chose inches.
Greg, you need to judge these right now.
OK, well, I'm giving John Kearns 1 point because he's done a series of lines.
1 point to John.
I'm giving 2 points to a woman who's drawn two fences, a pepper and an orange.
Fern Brady.
I'm giving 3 points to the long-legged lobster.
Congratulations, Munya.
I'm giving 4 points to the majestic horse of Troy. Being as it is, standing in twilight, waiting. But there's only one unicorn prancing in that row. Bam! Dara Ó Briain takes the 5 points.
Well done, Dara.
Come down, let's see how that's affected the final scores! Well, well, well.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we've learnt a lot there.
Oh, God, we have.
Much easier to have a 6-inch paintbrush than a 6-foot paintbrush.
Strapped to your head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I guess that's why that's what size they normally are. Well, it has been a one unicorn race with 19 points. The winner is Sarah Milliken!
Yes! Sarah wins! Please pop up to pocket your pants! Bye, everyone. Before we go, please cheer one more time for today's winner, Sarah Milliker!
Well, the task on Tuesday is practically perfect patisserie as Bake Off reaches the semis. All of the series so far is on all four if you've missed any. But next, 17 years after fleeing his childhood home, Taskmaster's Munya is going back to Zimbabwe to learn how a school teacher became one of the world's most feared dictators.